गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. सो इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द डिरेक्ट व्यू स्टोरेज ट्यूब, दैट इज DVST. सो फर्स्ट वी स्टडीड CRT डिस्प्ले डिवाइस. नाउ वी विल स्टडी डिरेक्ट व्यू स्टोरेज ट्यूब, दैट इज DVST डिस्प्ले डिवाइस. एंड इन बिटवीन दिस टू वी हैव स्टडिंग द टाइप ऑफ डिस्प्ले सिस्टम्स लाइक रास्टर स्कैन मेथड, रैंडम स्कैन मेथड, द मेथड्स वी यूज ऑन दिस डिस्प्ले डिवाइसेस. सो वट वॉज द प्रॉब्लम विथ CRT फॉर विच द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ DVST केम इन टू एग्जिस्टेंस. फर्स्ट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट. नाउ इन CRT रिफ्रेशिंग द स्क्रीन वॉज अ प्रॉब्लम. Now, why am I using the term refreshing? Because as I have said, the property of phosphor is that it illuminates very quickly and it gets decayed also very easily. So, it will decay. So, we have to provide a constant source of electrons, so and a constant source of refresh rates are there. That is, now we are sending electrons glowing. Again, we are sending electrons going. Again, we are sending electrons, it's glowing. So, in CRT, refreshing the screen was a problem as phosphor gets decay very easily. So, for refreshing the screen continuously, a lot of electricity is wasted and also a lot of memory is wasted. So, this was the major two problems which was observed in CRT, and in DVST, this two problems have been tried to get reduced. So these two problems have been reduced. Now when we have studied the vector scan display system and the raster scan display system, we knew that vector scan display have a concept of buffer memory. If I jot down in CRT, the problem was that the refreshing the screen was a problem, right? Why is that? Because a lot of electricity is wasted and memory is wasted. These two things are wasted. So these two, in DVST, we try to reduce these two. So, DVST tries to reduce these two factors. Right? Okay. Now, when we studied vector scan and raster scan, we saw that in vector scan, a buffer memory is there, right? Display buffer memory. And in that buffer memory, the info is stored. That is the about lines. That is like from which coordinate to which coordinate the line needs to be drawn, or what characters needs to be drawn, or which point needs to be highlighted on the screen. So all this information about the lines are stored in the buffer memory or the display buffer memory. And in raster scan, the same thing came with a name, that is frame buffer. In raster scan, what we have seen? Refresh buffer concept, that is the frame buffer concept. And in this frame buffer, what is stored earlier in vector, in the buffer memory, information is stored about the coordinates of the lines. But in raster scan, in frame buffer, information is stored about the pixel. Because from raster scan, the concept of pixel came into existence. So these two things we have seen. Now, in direct view storage tube, we will be using only the concept of electrons. Only using electrons only, how can we produce images? So, in CRT, we have seen the concept of a single gun. If you can remember, there was a single cathode grid. Right, so it was a single cathode system. So, a concept of in CRT, single gun was present, right? But here, if you notice the picture, two guns are present. First, the primary gun and then the flat gun. So, in DVST, two guns, that is two electron guns are present. One is the primary gun, another is the flat gun. Now, what is the work of these two guns? The primary gun, it is responsible for drawing the images. That is, it is solely responsible for storing the picture patterns. And the flat gun, which is also the secondary gun, it releases the electrons everywhere on the screen. Where the pattern needs to be drawn, that part is illuminated, rest is left as it is. If I want to make it more simple, I would say that primary gun, that is this gun, it is only responsible for storing picture patterns, that is for drawing the images. And the secondary gun, which is also known as the flat gun, it will just flood the electrons, that way it will just throw the electrons, that is, it releases electrons everywhere. Okay, it will release electrons everywhere on the screen where that pattern, but where the pattern needs to be drawn. That is, suppose I have a screen like this, and I on the screen like this, I want to draw this circle, right? So, what flat gun will do, it will release electrons everywhere on the screen where the pattern needs to be drawn, but that part is only illuminated. That is, this on my screen, this part will only be illuminated, rest will be left blank as it is. Okay, fine. Now, these two working principle of these two sections have been, I have just demonstrated. The next section, if I can see, is the, I have said that the focusing and the deflecting system. The same work that the focusing anode assembly used to do in the CRT, the same work this focusing and deflecting system will do. The work which was done by the anode assembly is to focus the electrons on the path towards the screen, and the work which the vertical and the horizontal deflection plates did was to make the movement of the electron in upward and downward and in right and left sections or patterns, right? Same work is done by the focusing and deflecting system in the DVST. That is, they will focus the electrons to grow in a straight path on the, towards the screen, and the deflecting system, what they will do is they will deflect the entire electron beam in upward and downward and left and right patterns so that electrons are flown everywhere on the entire screen from top to bottom, left to right, electrons can be flown. So these are the electrons which are going towards the screen. I have make dots to make you understand. So I have denoted that it is writing electron beam. That is, focusing anode is writing or focusing the electrons on the screen. Now, here comes the new concept. In CRT, there was no concept of storage grid. There was no concept of collector. But here, just before the screen came the concept of collector and the concept of storage grid. Now, what does these two things do? First, the storage grid will do what? The storage grid, it stores the image to be displayed on the screen. And what the collector will do? Collector takes away all the excess electrons. That is, the excess electrons which are present, it will take away. So, the storage grid does what? The storage grid over here, it first stores the image to be displayed on the screen. And what does the collector do? The collector takes away, or it attracts, or it takes away or consumes all the excess electron. Whatever excess electron which are not needed for displaying the image on the screen are present, it takes away or absorbs those electrons. Suppose I want to draw, this is my screen, and I want to draw a circle on my screen. Now, how does this storage and the collector and the screen will work in order to draw the circle? Now, what did I say? The primary gun, it stores the information about drawing images. It is responsible for drawing images. So, the primary gun has the information that it needs to show a circle on the screen. So, from primary gun, the electrons are released. And these electrons, it needs to go to the storage grid and then draw the pattern of the circle. So first, the primary gun needs to know, or the primary gun already knows that I need to draw a circle. Then from this primary gun, electrons are released. These electrons, they need to travel the entire way with the help of this focusing and deflection systems. And it needs to reach the storage grid. Because it needs to go to the storage grid, because it needs to tell the storage grid also that I need to draw a pattern, because the storage grid, it stores the image to be displayed on the screen. So the storage grid first needs to store the image of this circle in order to draw the image of a circle on the screen. Now, the primary gun, first, since the primary gun is there, what it will do? It will start releasing electrons here and there. With the help of focusing and deflection systems, the electrons should not go away like outside of the tube. It will go here and there, upward, downward, left, right on the storage grid. So, the primary gun, it throws the electrons everywhere on the storage grid. It first throws the electron. So, if I consider, suppose my system is like this. This is my tube. This is my tube, that is DVST. Here I have the screen. This is my storage grid. Suppose at first this is my storage grid, and then this is my storage grid. Then there is my collector, and then this side there is the screen, and this is the system, that is the tube. So electrons, so suppose if this is my storage grid, electrons will come from this side. So electrons are coming here and there it is growing. So here and there electrons are released on the storage grid. Now in the storage grid, there is a circle present, that is this circle is the information about the circle I need to draw on the screen. So this circle information is there. So when electrons will come, everywhere it will throw electrons on the storage grid. Right? Everywhere it will throw electrons on the storage grid, but except the grid circle area. Okay? So, everywhere else is charged with negative electrons except the circle area. It is not charged. So, what happens? Suppose this is a tube. Suppose the tube is like this. Here is the storage grid. Next is the collector. Next is the screen. So, if I suppose this is the storage grid, this is the collector, and this is the screen. Okay, and I am seeing from this side. I am sitting over here, I am seeing from this side. Okay, so first the primary gun knows that I need to draw a circle at this coordinate. Then this information is stored in the storage grid that this is the circle which needs to be drawn. So suppose this is my storage grid. So if electrons are coming like this, it will go everywhere like this pattern in the storage grid. So, whenever it will release electrons everywhere in the storage grid, so everywhere else except this circle area will be charged with negative electrons. Now, this flood gun, it throws electrons everywhere else. Now, when primary gun first comes and throws electrons everywhere except this circle, because primary gun has the coordinates where the circle needs to be drawn on the screen. So except this circle area, everywhere it will throw electrons, and in the storage grid everywhere will become negatively charged except the circle area. So this is the work of primary gun. What the flood gun will do next? the flat gun, it throws electrons everywhere else. So electrons will go here, electrons will go here, electrons will go here, electrons will go here. So what will happen? Electrons will repel each other. So it cannot pass. When it reaches the circle, there is nothing. So suppose the flat gun is throwing electrons on the storage grid again. Already the primary gun has thrown electrons everywhere there is a electrons. So when the flat gun is again throwing electrons everywhere on the storage grid, so this electrons, it cannot pass through here or through here. Why? Because electrons are already there. So electron will repel each other. But this section, the electrons can pass. Why? Because this section does not contain any electrons. So there will be a source of attraction. So the electrons will pass through this section. So the beam can pass through this section only. Now when beam can pass through this section, what will happen? This section I cannot pass, this section I cannot pass, this section I cannot pass, but this section I can pass. So when my beam will pass through this section, so this is the section which will be displayed on my screen, right? Everything else will not be displayed. This is my storage grid. Electrons was coming through here through the concept of primary gun. Everywhere else is charged. This portion was not charged. Then again flat gun will release electrons everywhere. Electrons will go here, there, here, there, here, there. Electron will repel each other. It cannot pass through. But this section, it was empty. So electron beam will definitely pass through this section. So when light will pass through this section, this portion will be illuminated and on the screen, this portion will be only be seen on the screen. And after electrons beam is passing through that portion and this portion will be illuminated on the screen, we will have this image that this circle is drawn on the screen. Okay. So we just need to keep the throwing the electrons and automatically this circle portion will be illuminated. This is the working procedure of DVST. First, there is a storage grid. So, primary guns will throw electrons. It will go everywhere on the storage grid except the portion where the image is to be displayed. So, when flat gun will again release electrons, all these sections will repel each other. It won't be passing through. But this section, there is nothing. So, the electron beam will pass through this section. And when electron beam will pass through this section, a replica of this section will be seen on the screen. And by this, we will be seeing the image of the circle. It can happen with letters, it can be characters, it can be complex images, it can be triangles, any shape it can be. But the concept is same. The shape of the image will be left blank from the primary gun. Then through that shape of the image, the flat gun will pass electrons. And when the flat gun will pass electrons through that shape of the image, that image will be displayed, or that replica or that image shadow will be displayed on the screen. So what are the advantages and disadvantages of the system? The first advantage is there is no need to refresh repeatedly. So there is no memory headache, because the problem of memory needs to be reduced. So for that DVST came into existence. So this concept of refreshing and the concept problem with refreshing the screen and continuously and having usage of memory is no longer there in DVST. The next thing is that any complex graphics images can be created. We can draw anything, any image. The major disadvantages with this system are that no color is displayed. That is, color we cannot display. And why we cannot display? Because we are only using the concept of electrons. We are not using the concept of pixels and something that we will be using the concept of color. Only image is there. That image shadow is kept. Electrons are passed through the shadow. First, electrons are passed on the storage grid, all the outer region of the image will be negatively charged with electron. Next, flat gun will pass electrons through the portion of the image, and that image shadow or the image portion will be reflected on the screen. So problem is, suppose I want to reflect, suppose I want to show the character A on the screen. So we will first display the character A on the screen. Suppose I want to, in the next minute, I want to show the circle on the screen. So what I will have to do, I will have to remove all the information about this A from the storage grid, and then I will be able to show the circle. So whenever we need to show something, we need to remove the entire content of the storage grid, that is the earlier content, whatever is there, we need to entirely remove the content of the storage grid, and then we can again display the next thing we want to display. So it takes certain time, so suppose 0.5 seconds, it takes time to remove and to show the next pattern. So this is the major drawback of DVST, that is a lot of time is consumed. But there is definitely still uses of DVST in areas where there is no usage of colors, that much color is not needed. We do not need to change the image repeatedly. Then high resolution pictures are not needed. Then suppose perfect accurate pictures are not needed. So in those areas where still there is high resolution pictures are not needed, perfect pictures are not needed, we do not need to change the image repeatedly. We do not need to use multiple colors also in the image. Simple black and white images will do. So in those areas, still the concept of DVST is there. So this was all about the topic direct view storage tube, how this entire system works. I hope you people have been able to understand.